gentlemen, with the Dead Pioneers. America's a pyramid scheme, and you ain't at the top. Comedy, and I had a chance to get a grant to expand it, and the idea was for us to build some original music that accompany this performance piece. It was about how I grew up in music. I grew up in Utah, and how important music was, and ultimately how important punk rock music was. And through the process, we accidentally put together a band, and so here we are. We lost one of our performers tonight for the whole thing tonight, so someone's at home with COVID.
Sandra is at home with COVID.
Yeah. So I was gonna keep it just the music, but I think we're gonna just throw a little bit of spoken words so we can elongate the process a bit. This piece is called Moving Day. The history books make Indian removal sound like an elaborate moving day, like signing treaties as signing a lease to the crappiest apartment in town. We are the middle children of America, and if we were the Brady Bunch, we'd be Jan Brady. This next song is a cover from a Miniman song called The Punchline. Love this song because it talks about, it's an ode to General George Armstrong Custer. I wrote this piece in about an hour, and then we got together and produced this. It's called Bad Indian. Yeah. Not a very good Indian, maybe even a bad Indian.
Thank you.
All of those stories are true, by the way. This is called The Art of Savagery. I was walking a line, minding my own indigenous business, hair flowing like the best Pantene commercial, when I was stopped in my tracks. A young girl, fair skin, bright eyed, eager to talk, eager to ask, "Are you a real Indian?" I've heard this question a million times from a million people, sometimes with eyes shining in romanticism, sometimes with eyes shining in skeptical colonialism, but a child's question is innocent, a true reflection of her world. Without malice, without years of wolf dancing, Cleveland Indianing, corporate sweat lodges, as Lewis is named Daniel, dancing and playing Indian all day. "Are you a real Indian?" "Yes, I am." To which her bright eyes got wide, her pigtails blowing in the wind of her flight. Screaming in fear, she ran. She had not the years of the world we live in. She carried someone else's years upon her adolescent shoulders. But now, an Indian quandary. Do I chase her and set her straight, thus perpetuating the fear she has of my perceived savagery? Or do I let her go, securing her fear of my perceived savagery? We are often required to walk a fine line of savagery because you're Indian if you do, and you're Indian if you don't. This year. Schedules are not yet, but keep an eye out, and we'll have some, hopefully a couple new songs as well. So we're working on something. It's called Dreamcatcher. We got to talk about appropriation and how absurd it is from this side. Dreamcatchers are misappropriated, meant for children. It captures nightmares, it lets the good dreams through, and you hang them from your rearview mirrors. Is your commute that much of a nightmare? Are you sleeping when you should be driving? Who are all these white people sleeping in their cars? And I don't understand your sleepy skin. Why is there a dream catcher tattooed on your body? Are you a nightmare? In my mind, the most adolescent punk song that speaks to the angst of growing up and being different is Circle Jerks' World Up My Ass. Here we go. We'll be right back. it's dope being here because when they were building this, Nathaniel Ratliff and his partner Bob, they asked me to do the mural on the side of the building. So on the screw side of the building, that's mine. People tagged on it, but that's the way it goes. This is not a political song. Just words. Thank you. So if you guys don't know, this is Abe. We got Dave on the bass. And I'm going to embarrass Shane a little bit here on the drums. This guy, I've never met anybody that's happier to play drums than this guy. We have another guitarist, Josh Rivera. He is in Indiana. He will join us for UMS. And Lee, who's just back from being on tour with Algiers. I don't think he's going to make it. I think he just broke his shoulder. He's recovering from that. This is called Doom Indian. While the whites wait for the apocalypse already took place. Articulating the past serves recognition to general trauma, but some folks are bummed out about it. Guilt or whatever. And then I'm just a Doom Indian. I hurt your fragile disposition with the weight of my words. See no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil, even if your grandfather was evil. So I'm the bad guy in this scenario. I'm the Doom Indian. You know, as Doom Indian, I speak doom all the time. I can't help it. Doom came to me. Doom sustains me. Recognition of doom is no longer a disposition or a description so much as a solid indigenous character. Doom is angry and real and could care less how it makes you feel. Doom Indian. Listen, it's okay if it bothers you. I'd be more concerned if you're okay with it. It's not awesome on some level either. Some kind of reconciliation. I don't know. There's a lot of work to do, and yeah, I'm hopeful and cynical, and I want to move forward in a good way, but I'm also angry. No matter how hard I try, I can't ignore anything. History. Slick progressive language, performative land acknowledgments, like public masturbation. Get your shit together, seriously, with love, Doom Indian. This song's called No One Knows Anything and Death is Real, and I got the title from a comedian named Kyle Kinane, where he points out to somebody that no one owns anything and death is real. And I, for some reason, think that's really funny. I continue to walk like a ghost in the graveyard of our thousand-year home. I look like a stranger out here, no matter where I continue to roam. You act so aloof, you're ignoring the proof that you're strangely so innocent. It seems dear, and you're so full of fear, and destruction is imminent. Oh, we told you, we told you, we told you this wouldn't work. I know you do, I know you do, and I can see your shoes. They took all the things that the earth brings to us in love and benevolence. In the beginning it was bad and it's still pretty sad, but you're wielding malevolence. My dagger is stuck in the right side of your gut and it doesn't seem to matter too much. You'll find me standing over your mind with nothing left to clutch. But we told you, we told you, we told you this wouldn't work. I know you knew, I know you knew, and I can hear you smirk. I know rise above it all. Put you on the edge of a cliff that will provide an excellent, excellent fall. Your last thought of me, and soon you will see that nobody really owns. The corpse will feed growing things on this earth, and you will die alone. So Google that shit, and yeah, we'll see you again.